Nova, The Impossible Flight is a film that lives at the intersection of adventure and clean energy. The program follows brave pilots and engineers who risked their lives to fly the first solar-powered airplane across the globe without a drop of fuel. Here's a sneak peek.
A feat never before attempted.
To dot a flight around the world with no fuel.
Powered only by the light of the sun.
It's completely crazy. It's very dangerous.
Can the batteries last 5 nights over the Pacific Ocean?
Someone has to do it first.
A daring test of technology.
Someone has to try.
The Impossible Flight on Nova.
Renewable energy is an important answer to the difficult question of climate change. And here to tell us more about this film is its senior executive producer, Paula Apsell. Paula, welcome to the program.
Thanks very much. It's my pleasure to be here.
So first of all, tell me, what drew you to this story?
Well, when the producers from Far West Productions, Noel Dockstetter and Quinn Kenaly, first presented this idea, it just seemed like, as you actually said, a fabulous intersection between something very, very important, renewable energy, and adventure and exploration. And that's really the sweet spot for Nova. That's what our viewers love to see. They love to see something that's technically very difficult, a problem that is solved, matched with an adventure that has an important purpose. And so it just was an irresistible lure. Although I have to say, we were afraid of two things.
Mm-hmm.
One, we were afraid that the trip around the world would go off without a hitch, and that would seem very boring. And we were also afraid because going 26,000 miles around the globe in a solar-powered plane without a drop of fuel is so improbable and so dangerous that we were also afraid that something terrible would happen.
I was going to say, this is certainly a film that has its tense moments of drama. One of the ones that stands out the most, of course, is the 5-day flight from Japan to Hawaii. Tell me a little bit about why that took 5 days and what made it so dangerous.
Well, it took 5 days because the Pacific Ocean is simply the largest ocean on Earth. It's really big, and it takes that much time to cross it in a plane that goes about 45 miles an hour, which is what Solar Impulse did. And so there were a tremendous number of obstacles, and it was a very dicey decision whether to take off from Nagoya, Japan at all, because there were all sorts of flight restrictions that the Japanese imposed on the flight, which didn't give them an optimal path. And there were a lot of weather problems. The monsoon season was beginning in Japan. And right as they started, they were confronted with two problems. I also have to say that they had a team of meteorologists who were fantastic. But the further you go, the number of days from the takeoff point, the lower your confidence in your weather report goes. So if you have to fly for 5 days, the confidence just sinks for those last 2 days. Now, so they took off from Nagoya with Andre Borschberg flying. And the first thing they had was their autopilot surveillance system called the MAS. Starts to beep constantly. And it was just kind of working overtime for some reason. And that made the electronic system in the plane questionable, which of course worried flight control back.
Certainly.
And it also kept waking Andre up. So he, you know, they sleep in cat naps of 20 minutes each. And it's really important for 5 days and nights. It's not possible for a human being to stay up that long. So they're very worried about pilot exhaustion as well as the electronics.
But the plane did land, and that is the most important part. Not to give away a spoiler alert, but the plane did land.
Through all of these things, Andre was just very confident. You know, he was a fighter pilot in the Swiss Air Force, and he believed that the plane felt good. And so the intuition of the pilot carried the day. really, flight control, mission control in Monaco wanted him to go back to Nagoya, Japan. You have to see, this team has the pilots' lives in their hands. They are concerned about it constantly. But Andre overruled them and said, we have to go on. He just felt the plane was flying so well. And as you say, the plane did land successfully and without any terrible incidents happening in Hawaii.
Well, listen, Paula Apsell, this is amazing film to watch just to see what the possibilities are. And it's also a beautiful film to watch just visually. So thank you so much for bringing this to us and to Nova.
You are very welcome. And I hope that everybody watches it on January 31st on Nova. Of course, check your local listings. And thanks very much for your questions.
You almost took the words right out of my mouth. Nova, The Impossible Flight is a 2-hour special premiering on 13, Wednesday, January 31st at 9 p.m.